Adding motion blur is an integral part of the post-production pipeline. It allows you to add this to graphics and other moving elements to make it feel unified within a shot. In situations where you have footage that you want to speed up or slow down, you can perfect motion blur in post to give you the best end result. Now, the best motion blur effects depend on the accuracy of motion vectors, which are tricky to calculate with traditional optical flow methods because of the complexity of pixel motion often present in real-life video. This is where our AI comes to the rescue, predicting accurate motion vectors for the most complex moves in your shot. This is where Boris FX's Continuum 2025 comes into play with our new effect, BCC plus Motion Blur ML, powered by machine learning. It adds motion blur automatically to your clip, giving you a variety of different ways that you can perfect the look. Let's take a look at how we can use Motion Blur ML in our own workflow. Okay, I'm here inside of Premiere Pro, and I have a clip here that I would like to add motion blur to. I'll make this full frame, and I have retimed this in post during the wraparound here of the statue in order to create a more dynamic feeling to match up with some audio effects. The problem is the way that it was shot is it is sharper than what it would be intended if I did speed this up in camera. This is where Motion Blur ML comes into play. In order to apply it to the clip, first of all, I need to nest it in order to change the order of operations. So I'm going to right click and choose nest from the menu. Let's call this Motion Blur ML. I'll press OK. And on the nest, let's head over to our effects tab, pressing Shift 7. And I'll apply BCC plus Motion Blur ML from the BCC Blur category. Immediately, because my playhead was parked over the fast moving motion, you should see that there's much more motion blur applied to the clip. I'm going to press Shift 5 to go to my effect controls. And a handy way of comparing before and afters using BCC plus effects is using the compare mode. I'll change this from off to side by side, where we see the original clip on the left, and of course our motion blur added clip here on the right. Now, your two most important controls in this effect are shutter angle and shutter phase, and they are based off of real world cameras. They allow for more light to be entered into the camera, which affects motion blur. So the higher the shutter angle, the more motion blur you're going to get. If we wanted to change this based off of real world cameras, the maximum amount would be 360, which I'll enter here, which would allow for more motion blur here in your shot. And what you're going to want to do with your shutter phase is have the 360 number divided by -2. So in this instance, it will be a value of -180. We can see there that we get a lot more motion blur here on our shot. What I'm going to do is just simply reset those parameters, turn off the side-by-side view, and let you see the default result full frame. And we can clearly see that extra added motion blur on the clip on the remapped rotation. Let's take a look at another common example, and that's working with text and graphics inside of a nonlinear editor. I just so happen to have a piece of lower third text that moves or travels across the screen from screen left to screen right. And during those moments of motion, we can see that it's clear and crisp. Now, some nonlinear editors don't even have the possibility of controlling motion blur from inside the host, or the tools that are available are somewhat limited. In this particular case, like I did with my remapped shot, I'm going to right click and choose nest, and we'll call it lower third ML. Let's head back to the effects tab, where I'll double click motion blur onto the shot. Looking at effect controls, let's take a look at a few additional options. And in order to see this, I'm going to change my screen view to 200% and then just use these scroll bars in order to get nice and close to the text. It's best to take a look at this with lower samples. So I'm going to lower the sample, which is kind of like a quality sample, determines the samples of motion blur being created. We can see here now set to 4. One option we have is changing the direction of the motion blur. Currently set by default to forward, we could set that to reverse, or we can blend both reverse and forward by selecting both. This usually gives the best quality options of motion blur, and you could also change the model. By default, the model is set to an optical flow of faster, but we can always change that to better at the expense of longer render times. Now that that's set, I'll increase the sample value back to its default of 24, and let's fit this to the screen where we can now take a look at this in full frame. A lot more motion blur is added with that both direction and higher quality output from our model. Let's take a look at one more example of how we can extend motion blur even further for stylistic looks. So I have a sequence here called Hyperlapse, and I've taken this original shot and I've sped it up to 500% using BCC plus Retimer ML. And I would like to have a much more streaky look than the one that's here. Let me park on the frame that we want to look at when we are adjusting the effect. And I'm just gonna right click that clip and choose to nest it. We'll call this Hyper ML. I'll press okay. And like we've done before, let's go to the effects tab. And with the selected layer, let's double click to apply the default motion blur ML. I'm gonna move my frame a bit forward so we can see the most streaky part of the train, and just press Shift 5 in order to get to my effect controls. Now, one way of visualizing this motion blur is with our colorized flow output. To change this, we simply go to output where it's currently motion blur and choose colorized flow. Okay, so what we're seeing is a visual representation of the motion vectors from this image compared to other frames. You'll notice that when I switch the direction from forward to reverse, the motion vectors change. And we'll also notice that during moments of fast motion, colors are gonna be more vibrant in their color compared to if there's no motion, you'll actually see completely white. So we can use this as a guide to help us. Let me park myself on that 118 frame again. While we're changing the direction of our motion blur, such as to both, so we can see the overlap, not to mention our model output. In this case, I'm gonna set this to better to help us generate our ideal final result. Let me hop out of this and go back to motion blur. And you should note that you can take your shutter angle and shutter phase amounts and ramp this up to values that you can't achieve with a physical camera. In this instance, I'm gonna drag the shutter angle upwards, paying attention to the train. No way that we can bring it up to a really extreme amount, but let's settle on a value of 450, making that divided by -2 for the shutter phase and make this -225. Now, an important value that can help you achieve a better looking motion blur when you ramp up these amounts is the smoothness value, which I'll set all the way to 100. In the case that you wanted to limit how far out the motion blur goes, there is a limit motion option that can be controlled by the max amount of motion, not so desirable in the case of the streakiness that we're looking to complete. Last but not least, with all BCC plus effects and true of our ML tools, we have a mocha mask and track section where we could integrate pixel chooser into the shot, but that's not what we want so much for this end result. Now looking at our cranked up shutter angle and shutter phase with the optical flow set to better and a more extreme smoothness, let's look at this final result rendered out. And there is our final result with the train, and let's just see that with a comparison with the original shot. And those are a few ways that you can integrate BCC plus Motion Blur ML into your editing workflow. For more information about Continuum 2025 or to sign up for a free trial, head over to borisfx.com. For more tips and tricks just like this, don't forget to subscribe and check out more of this on our channel. Thanks so much for watching.